In America, there is a famous basketball league called the NBA. And in the NBA, they have something called the Hall of Fame. This is where all past great players are, in a sense, enshrined and remembered for all ages. People who have been good rebounders, people who have been the top scorers, people who have been the best players, the elite, the stars, are all named in the Hall of Fame. Have you ever wondered, what is the Hall of Fame for the man of God? What is it that unites man of God in this Hall of Fame in a Christian life? You would say, well, it's loyalty to God. That's true. Humility, yes, that's true. Faith in God, absolutely. Obedience to Him, that is also spot on. Loyalty, humility, faith, obedience, I think these things are essential in the Hall of Fame in a Christian life. But there's something else I see in the Bible, and I think it is pain. Yes, what unites great men of God is pain. James 5 and verse 10 tells me, "Take, my brethren, the prophets who have spoken in the name of the Lord for an example of suffering, affliction, and of patience." In other words, the prophets who are before us are an example of suffering, affliction. They have all gone through pain, and they are, in a sense, in a Hall of Fame, and they're marked out by their sufferings. In fact, if you read Hebrews 11, which people commonly call the Hall of Faith, I can easily say that it is the Hall of Pain, because every single one of them had great pains, even in their earthly pilgrimage. Some were sawn, some were burned, some were torn, but yet they were in a Hall of Fame, of faith. Now think about it today. There are churches and people who teach a pain-free life. They say, believe in Jesus and there'll be no pain today on earth for you. But let's remember what Scripture says. There is a Hall of Pain that marks out the great men of God. Not that we seek for pain, but that we need to recognize pain is real. And we can rejoice if we are called to be in such positions of sufferings and pain. Why? James 5:11, "Behold, we count them happy which endure. You have heard of the patience of Job and have seen the end of the Lord, that the Lord is very pitiful and of tender mercy." So James says, "Behold, we count them happy which endure." And like Job in verse 11 here, as we go through pain, we will be privileged to know experientially the tender mercy of the Lord. My friends, I want to encourage your heart. If you are in pain today, you are in good company. And God has His purposes, and God will reveal Himself to you in a deep, deep way. He cries out, He shouts out to you in your pain, and so you today can count yourself happy which endure. God bless.